Hello, hello. Good evening po sa inyong lahat. I hope I'm coming very clear with your sounds. I want to hear. I also want to see if I'm really coming there clearly so that I can proceed very, very. Yan. Papakita po muna ako sa inyo ng konti. Yan. Okay. Hello. Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. I hope I'm coming really clear. Because I will be able to show you some of the slides that will definitely help you during today, after treatment, and also the recovery period. I also show you that the KANO, this is the new term for how much, because you have used to asking a lot of suppliers, KANO, now is the right time to perfectly answer for patients coming in, KANO, magkano, how much, now is the time, right time for you to answer. Okay, so I hope I can begin. But before we begin with the presentation, I would just like to give greetings to Dr. Ann Garcia, Dr. G. Devella Villa, Dr. Kevin Mirasol, good evening, magandang gabi, Dr. Bel Carandang, Dr. Edith Abuyo, Dr. Melody Mendoza Rivera, Dr. Ariel, Dr. Kaidik. I will be giving you a very, very good one, very good presentation today. I hope I'll be able to also able to give you, deliver what you are expecting for tonight's presentation. I'll proceed, okay? So I want to be able to proceed with the slides presentation. Am I coming clear? Dr. Elizabeth, is it clear? Can I have an answer for you? Dr. Villacorta Mendoza, am I clear? Dr. Ann Ace, Larry Ocampo, am I very clear? My voice is quite clear. So we do have a lot of watchers today. So I hope they enjoy the music. Let's proceed. Okay, so the title of this presentation is not about this picture. No, this is not the title, it's not this one, because this is just a book, which I hope you also subscribe to my YouTube channel. This is a great opportunity. So the topic for today's presentation, three relevant things with the bonus slides on tips on how to do marketing plans. So what are those three relevant things that we have to remember and we have to know? So simple things, no? Number one, bago po tayo magsimula, sino ba itong Mr. Roche Ruiz neto, the founder of Dental Marketing Philippines? Who am I? Of course, sorry, these are just some of the, para makilala niyo po ako ng gusto, I am the president of KJR Dental Clinics. We do have two dental clinics in the south. So this is in Las Piñas and in Parañaque. I'm also the president of KJR Dental Center Distributions. I'm also founder of Dental Marketing Philippines. Lecturer, organizer din po tayo ng mga events ng Smiling Aesthetics, wherein we have partnered with several local dentists in the country, and also the vice president. So I'm very proud of this organization, the Philippine Advocates for Consultants and Trainers. So we are the community of consultants, trainers, and experts, wherein we really help a lot of businessmen, small, medium, or micro, small, medium enterprise. That includes clinic. No, so we are basically sharing all of this one. Thank you, Dr. Larry, for giving us the thumbs up. And I'm also the founder of Master Academy, wherein we also give courses for dental practitioners, dental managers, and of course, dental clinic owners. And the former also, you know, former director of BioHealth Link Singapore. So I do have a business in Singapore. Former general manager of PBM ProBiomed Pharma Company. Pero wala pong kwenta yung lahat na. No? Huwag niyo pong pansinin yung mga accomplishment na yon, because I'm just here. Simpleng mamamayan, simpleng tao na gustong tumulong sa mga dentista na gusto naman lumaki ang kanilang mga negosyo. Alam nyo, ang presentation po namin ni Dr. Kevin last May 10 was all signifies that we do have a lot of dentists who would want to be successful in their business. And this is also a great opportunity in collaboration with that presentation of digital dental marketing. So, yours truly is a keynote speaker and chairman of the 2018 International Dentistry and Dental Marketing in Boston, Massachusetts. So, it's really a very favorable thing for Filipino dentists, so we'll be able to represent the Philippines. And of course, no, ito po yung nakita nyo kanin sa page, author of dental marketing book. Ang title po niyan, I've Met Stupid Dentists. No, marami po nagtatanong, ay bakit kaya I've Met Stupid Dentists? Tanongin nyo po yung sarili nyo, stupid ba ako? No. Okay, so this is a marketing way of how to do business. So this is a great avenue, this is a great, great book, and I'm encouraging everyone. Although ako po yung author, medyo self-lifting po ito. But I definitely would like to give you a copy, or you must have a copy of this particular book. This is a very good book. definitely all my learnings will be shared in this particular book. Okay? So, ang pinaka-importante pong katangian ng inyong maliit na tao, maliit po ako na, ako po ay from Batangas, but I also help build, market, expand, and grow practice because I do research. As a matter of fact, yung International Journal of Oral and Dental Health, nandun po yung research natin. 2019, my research was published and that research is all about dental marketing in the Philippine setup. Okay? So, marami pong salamat. And marami po akong nakasama mga dentist na we're able to have two phases of study and 150 and 120 dentists were asked and also several lecturers, several officers and also some PRC. I'm also a dental marketing lecturer and this is the most important one. I help dentists attain a certain level of success based on his, her planned out targets and objectives. So maraming nagtatanong po, ano po yung planned out objectives? What are the targets? So pumapasok na ba sa isipan nyo that there's definitely a need for you to have a planned out target and objectives. We'll talk about that more in a little later. Ano po? So, let's proceed. So, the topic today is gonna be very, very long. Ang dami pang pag-uusapan natin, no? I'm sure you're gonna get a lot of learnings from this and this is gonna be exciting. I will try my best to share with you what I've done wrong, what I've done right, and also all the wisdom that I've gathered through the years of experience. I've been in the business for 21 years doing marketing. So I basically know what I'm doing in terms of marketing. And sabi po nila, gaano po katagal yung presentation natin? Naku, ang dami pong lecture ngayon, ang daming webinar ngayon. But this is a great opportunity for you to learn about three phases of dentistry. No? Ano po yung magagawa nyo during, after recovery, and also the recovery of this particular pandemic. And also, I want to be able to share with you sa mga dentista ko pong minamahal, Dr. Abe, Dr. Myla, Dr. Arceli, Dr. Maria Fe, Dr. Noel De Leon, magarami pong salamat sa inyo, Dr. Marie. I want to be able to show you yung tunay pong kaganapan ngayon po, no, sa new norms, the step-by-step procedures na ipapakita ko po sa inyo. Okay? Ito po yung sa aming gagawin. So this can be replicated. You can take just you can take notes. You can, if you do have papers, if you do have pencil, or if you have your cell phone with you can take pictures. Okay lang po yan sa akin. Wala pong problema. You can duplicate that or dagdagan niyo lang ng logo niyo. Okay lang po yan sa akin. And the last part is kano. No? How much? Yan. So how much is the new norm? Got so much how much and kano is now the. So I'll be discussing with you three very, very good topic today. But if we still have time, so I'm gonna cut off at 7:30, yun po yung maximum natin, no? So just forgive me if we're gonna be out by 7:30 because medyo matagal na po yung 7:30. So we started on time, so 1.5 hours. I think it can be done. Plus, I will try to help each and every dental clinic because dental clinic will be able to give you a marketing plan. Okay. So meron po ba kayong marketing plan? Matanong ko nga po kayo, no? So, Dr. Wilma, do you have a marketing plan? Because business, dental clinic is a business, so you should have marketing plan. So these are the top three questions I gathered from the start of this pandemic. What will I expect when I open my clinic? Where to start? How to start? What is the situation now? How much will I charge now? Will I lower? When pag na-open na po yung pwede na tayo mag-practice, will I lower it to get momentum or high to get back on sales traction? What about consultation and HMOs? Nako, ito po yung kadalasan tinatanong sa atin, no? And maraming salamat po sa lahat ng nanonood. I hope you'll be able to learn. You can share this and you can comment so that I will shout it out, no? So, makinig po, tingnan po itong slides na to, namnamin. And this dental webinar will help you get millions and may even help your business to survive in the upcoming years. Pero huwag niyo po kalimutan yan nasa taas. So dental business is on the verge of downfall. Your dental business will soon die. This is not to scare you, but to warn you, inform you, and give you positivity and action plans. So today, this presentation, we're going to give you action plans on how to survive and how to get to sales traction. Okay? Because we cannot hide the fact that we are really on the verge of downfall. A lot of restaurants closes down. A lot of other essential businesses have closed down. And dental clinic is no exception. Why? later on, makikita nyo po, no? You are, or we are, the most exposed in terms of health practitioner. And that alone is scary. That is really scary. But don't worry. That's why we are here. That's why Dental Marketing Philippines is here to help you out. And I firmly believe that we can give you positivity, and because we also provide you some action plans. Okay. So this is another scary thing. No? This is also a warning pala. So corporate practice is now creating a marketing plan to steal your market patients very soon. Ngayon po, no? They are meeting. They are meeting. They are planning, and they are creating strategy on how to do it. They also have logistics and resources to do that. So we have to have this understanding. We have to have this realization that corporate dentistry, if you're not going to adapt to change, if you're not going to listen to Dental Marketing Philippines, if you're not going to do a dental digital marketing, if you're not going to adapt to several action plans and to several changes that this pandemic will brought. We will bring to us, definitely we will be eaten alive. Okay, so thank you very much for that understanding. I want to share with you, this is just a classic example why contradicting to my first statement, why dentistry is a good business. Why dentistry is a good business. Back 2018 po, I did a research, and I've been researching a lot since this pandemic. And but before even this pandemic reached us, this is already part of the slides. Global dental business is gonna be reaching $60 billion by 2024. So we do have 5 years of forecasted growth. Okay? So ang dami pong pagkakataon bago po itong pandemic na ito. So pinapakita ko po that this is still a good business. Pakita ko rin po, next slide, is what do you need to know after 4 years? I think I was able to discuss this this presentation, and this part, this slide is also part of that presentation in the last convention, in the last chapter kung saan po ako nag-lecture. What do you need to know after 4 years? Or what do you need to know during this course of 5 years? So, up to 2024. No, 2018, I was doing research. 2019, I was doing research. And lagi ko po sinasabi sa mga dentista, you have a good business. You're going to be reaching, you're going to be attaining, or you're going to be getting a lot of traction in terms of sales. You're going to have 500,000, minimum 300,000. You're going to have 1 million a month sales only for your dental practice. Wow, a lot of dentists are so excited. Yes, you have to be excited. Yes, you have to be excited. Why? Because based on the research, no? This is from the Pitch Solution Academy. 25% increase in cases for that particular term in 4 years. And there will be 32.5% increase in profit. As you can see, if the cases increase, the more that the profit will increase. Tama? So, dentistry is a very good business. Okay? But I want you to understand, dear dentist, dear colleagues, that your profession is your practice, and your clinics is your business. Why? Because business, your clinic must be able to provide information, must be able to provide salary, must be able to have inventory, must be able to pay taxes, and your practice, you have to practice your profession, you have to learn discipline, you have to have a lot of learnings, you have to have a lot of techniques and tips on how to practice your craft. And that is what we call your PTR. So when you have PTR, it doesn't mean that you can do business. Now, PTR means is permit to practice. So you can be able to practice your profession and not do business by opening a corporation. You can sell a lot of things. So you must have single proprietorship, partnership, or a corporation. But that is not part of the topic today. So we'll have more discussions on that probably in the next few slides. Okay? So, ito po, na-discuss na last May 10, Dr. Kevin, but I want to be able to show you the marketing. So, marketing involves a lot of discipline also, no? Para pong dentistry yan, meron pong pediatrician, meron pong periodontologist, meron pong surgeon, meron pong iba-ibang discipline. That's just like in marketing. Basically, ang marketing po yung pinaka-mother, no? So, marketing has branding, trademark, logo, so discipline. So, it has a lot of discipline. And besides branding and trademark logo if you want to make your own logo, although Dental Marketing Philippines can provide you help and support with the logo design. You just can go to online logo maker. Okay. Why is it logo very important? Na-discuss natin po ito na Dr. Kevin, because this is your personality. What is your favorite color? If you want to incorporate that, so you may do so. Alright? So, the technique in creating a logo, na-discuss na rin po ni Dr. Kevin, just to reiterate, you can create the maximum of 3 different kinds of colors. Okay? So, let's proceed. And all businesses must start with vision. And dental clinic is no exception. You should always start with a vision and supplemented by a mission. So if I'm going to ask Dr. Cora Balde Lopez, Dr. Leticia Pagaduan, Dr. Nick Recto, hiya po, Dr. Cora Valdez, Dr. Leonie, Dr. Grace, what is your mission and what is your vision? Not only personal level, but your dental clinic. Dr. Abe, Dr. Cecilia, Dr. Wilma. So what is your mission? What is your vision? Yes. I truly understand. Naintindihan ko po kayo. Maraming salamat po. At nanonood kayo. Ngunit ito po ay para sa inyong negosyo. Ito po ay para sa minamahal niyong profesyon. We must have a vision. We must have a mission. Okay. So paano ba gumawa niya na sa Roche? No? Ano ba namang ang hirap naman ang pinapagawa mo? Hindi po ito mahirap. This is the first thing that you should do in planning and creating strategy on how to do business. Vision. Ano ba yung vision? Vision is your desired or your position and or your destination. If, sabi po ni Dr. Arnel, sabi ni Dr. Glandy, I want to be the best dental clinic in my barangay. Okay? Or I want to be, let's change it, no? I want to be the best dental clinic in the country. Okay? Do you think you can really do that? Yes, you can do that. But it takes a lot of time. Probably, usually, your vision or probably your mission changes every 5 to 10 years. So, you might want to start, if you want to have this, I want to be the best dental clinic in the city of Quezon City. And also, the other vision is, I want to be the best orthodontal clinic in the province of Quezon. I want to be the best cosmetic dentist in Batangas. So you can be able to do that. Once you are the best dental clinic in that particular area, then you can expand and you can get out of your comfort zone. Okay? Malinaw po. Okay? Ang bilis naman magsalita ni Sir Roche. De, sige, babagalan po. De, because we are going to have a lot of topic today, so I wanna really finish this on time, and I wanna share with you all the wisdom and knowledge that I acquired during the course of this year. And sorry. So, we must have a vision. We must have a vision. Okay? So, pag sinabi pong vision, malinaw na malinaw, pag upo mo sa bahay, you have your pencils, you have your papers with you, no? You have to know where you want to be, your position, or your desired destination. And next, mission naman. Pag-usapan naman natin itong mission na ito. Mission defines business or defines objectives or process. Okay? So if your business is dental clinic, I think you provide a very good smile to every patient that I will see. So, Dr. Anomi, Dr. J, Dr. Anisi, magandang gabi po, Dr. Jacob, wow, Dr. Romeo, Jacob, I'm pretty sure you're sabi niya, you're taking down notes, wow, you're my idol, I'm gonna see you on May 15th. Next, so this is just a classic example, this is from Hansen Dentistry. So, lahat po ng mission and vision should always be visible in your dental clinic. I wanna ask you again, no? Sensya na po kaya. Malakas ang boses ko. Sumisigaw ba ako? Hindi. Mabilis na magsalita. Tama po. Because I wanna give emphasis to this. All your vision and mission should be visible in your dental clinic so that when the patient comes in, they know what to expect. They know what is your vision. They know what is your mission. Ah, gusto pala ni doktora magbigay ng magandang ngiti sa amin. So sa tingin ko, paglabas ko dito, maganda ang ngiti ko. Okay? Example, it is our mission to exceed expectation by providing exceptional dental care. So once the patient saw that right away, you're going to be building relationship and trust with it. Alright? You get it? Okay? So maraming salamat po sa panonood. Maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat. And vision statement, our vision is to provide our patients with the dental experience that will promote a lifelong relationship built on trust, confidence, quality of work. Wow! This is a great, great vision from Hansen Dentistry. Yeah. pwede nyo pong gayahin to, konti lang, i-tweak nyo lang. Sorry ha. Pero mas maganda po yung original. No? So it should always come from the mind, from the brain, it should always come from the heart, and your passion. Next, sample, kay Rogers Dental Center. Ang mission niya po is to be committed to excellence in all of our services to our patients so that they may help them achieve the highest level of dental care appropriate to their needs. So, yan. Nakita niyo po yung word appropriate for their needs in an atmosphere of trust and compassion. You can take photo and you can take it out. Then, vision statement. We will adapt, grow, and evolve with our profession and society. So, these are the things that really makes you different. Right? Okay. Next. So, sample. Ang iba po, meron pong vision. Ang iba, merong mission. Pero ang iba po, meron tayong tinatawag na core values. As you can see on the right side of your screen, there is a core values. Pero let's talk about the vision. Oral health for better health. Parang pwede rin po yung tagline, no? Our mission, lead improvement in oral health for all Victorians. As you can see, no? Dental Health Services Victoria, meron po siyang specific niche. Now, we're gonna discuss that also a little later. Our values, so ang core values po ni Dental Health Services Victoria is respect, is acting with respect, accountable, collaboration, and transform. So as you can see, it's not just your vision, it's not just your mission, but there is also what we call core values. Tama po ba ako? Dr. Fatima, Dr. Marie de Guzman, maraming salamat po. I also want to share with you, no? Nandito na rin ako. I want to share with you because our mission and vision is stated, no? We have a core values. May napapansin po ba kayo sa ating mga core values? Okay? Let's start with respect for life, no? Every patient that will come into our office, we are respecting them. Okay? Number two, ultra pure service. Ito po, naka-patent na po ito, ha? Huwag niyo pong gayahin. Akin po ito. So, ultra pure service. So, we want to be able to provide more than white or translucent service to all of our patients. Okay? Marami pong salamat sa mga nanonood. And letter I, integrity. When we do our thing, when we treat our patients, we have to have that kind of integrity. When they get up, when they present themselves to the crowd, no? There's a reflection of our integrity. And zealousness, you can see crystal clear that we are truly compassionate and we are true to our word and we are true to our craft. And that is Ruiz. Okay? So, nakakuha naman po kayo ng idea. You can also do that. If your surname is Jacob, then probably you can start with J-A-C-O-B, Dr. Recto, R-E-C-T-O, Dr. J. Roquillo, Dr. Reyes, Dr. Vicky, Dr. Dina. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you come in on time and we are also discussing what you need to do in your business. I want to share with you, no? So now that we are sharing KGR Dental Center, ang branding po namin, no, is local branding. When we talk about local, I'm pretty sure you have an idea. So we want to make sure that we cater also global market, but we have a local visibility. Just like our clinic po is in Las Piñas in Parañaque, we have a local visibility just like that. We do have patients from New Zealand. We do have several patients from Australia, USA, Canada, Amsterdam, Spain. And once you were able to set a target, for example, you're setting a target of, example lang po ito, of 250,000 in a month in one particular clinic, no? For just for the whole month. Let's say for the whole month na po, example naman, maliit lang po, no? But if you were able to get one or two patients that will be able to provide you 250,000, no? For example, nagpa-check up po, nagpa full dentures or nagpa zirconia yung pasyente, dalawa, and they will, you have a charge of 250,000 or take 125 sila in just 2 days. I firmly believe that you do have, you deserve to have a rest for 28 days. So that's how you create a target. And that's how you create a level of certainty. That's how you create the level of happiness. That's how you create a level of understanding that your target will give you an opportunity to grow more. Okay? So, in creating a target, we have what we call the target market. Okay? So target market. When we talk about target market, is a group of customers within the business serviceable. So lahat po ng, sige po, ito, kadalasan po ng mga dentist na sinasabi, sino po yung target market mo? So because I do a lot of alignment, I do a lot of consultation with the dental businesses. Kahit sino. Kung sino pumasok, patay. Okay, so that is a very, very classic answer. There's nothing wrong with that, no? That's why we are here to help. And we want to be able to show you the different niche. No? So if you're starting a business, probably I will still give you an opportunity, I'll give you a chance that you can do that. But once you reach a level of introduction to the market, to the marketplace or the competing world in business, because your business, your clinic is a business, and the business is clinic, you have to have your niche. Huwag po kayong mag-alala if your Capit clinic is already doing its niche. We have enough for everybody. So you can think about this, no? So if you want to target CEOs or office workers, kailangan connected po ang inyong working hours or open hours. So you might want to open your clinic on Sundays kasi kadalasan po, ito po, alam nyo naman po ito. Lagi nyo pong nakikita na Sunday for appointment. If it's Sunday for appointment, meaning to say you are open Monday to Saturday or Monday to Friday, and your office, the office workers and even the president or even the management level of the company is really busy working on that particular day. So that would not give you the satisfaction if that is your target. So it will always depend on the target. Like tourism, if you're expats, foreigners, your target is students. Or if you want to target barangay and community, so everything depends on your vision. Everything depends on your mission. Everything depends on your target market. Malino po. Okay? Next. And we have this one. You know, when I go around to the dental clinics for the consultation, a lot of dentists, I usually ask dentists, Doctor, what is your sales target? Huh? the dentist will ask me, huh? Kailangan mo yun? Ah, may target kami, 500. Doktor, nasaan? Nasaan po yung nakasulat? Hindi, basta ito yung target namin, pag gano'n na, ha? Okay, so everything should have a written sales target. Okay? So setting up sales target helps you and your team focus on achieving your goals. Okay? So again, thank you very much. And just give you a classic example. This is on a per clinic. Now that we're talking KJR Dental Practice, so this is on a per branch basis. No? But before I proceed with this, I'd like to say hi to Dr. Jessica, Dr. Dina, Dr. Ems Pobre Navarrete, Dr. Balot Maldin, Dr. Aniktik, and Dr. Aniktik, Dr. Lien Anidem Medina, to, Medina. So Dr. Neil Medina, from Batangas, from Taal, no? I'm sure you're enjoying stay with the family, but of course you wanted to open up a clinic. Dr. Maynary from Iloilo, maraming salamat po sa inyo. Napakalaki po na implement niyo para sa akin sa pag-open ng new clinic. Visit po ulit ako sa clinic niyo po ni Doc pag-uwi ko po. Ay, wow! Thank you very much, Dr. Maynary. I'm pretty sure you get a lot of inspiration, but this is just, no, this is just a mission of yours truly. And this your comments really makes me wanna go and wanna help more dentists to do good in their practice, no? Just like what I said earlier po, I wanna be able to show you and share with you some of the wisdoms and knowledge that I've gotten throughout the years of experience. So let's proceed with this. Let's go back to the slides. Target per month. So it must be specific. Tama po. You should have this specific target market. So when you get home, or maybe when we open up your practice again, probably July or July, August, September, or maybe November, October. Dako, tagal pala nyo si Roche. So when you open your clinic, no, it will go back to a recovery period. So you wanna, baka gusto nyo pag-isipan to set up a target. So a target is 500,000. Let's say hitting an average of 89% every month. If you're hitting 89% every month, that is a so good business. So before this pandemic, business is good. Challenge is part of dental business, of course. Planning of expansion. We are actually planning up an expansion. We are also planning on renovation. And we are planning of buying sophisticated equipment specifically for infection control and restoration. So probably matutupad po ito lahat because we are really anticipating infection control procedures. Okay. So, Dr. Noslens, tingnan natin. 500,000. So, this is the sales. So when we are in business, of course you do it sales, but of course in your inside clinic, you wanna gusto niyo pong tawagin ng treatment procedures or treatment fee or payment of the patients, bahala po kayo. But in general terms, this is considered sales. Okay, so we do have an expenses there. Laboratories, 100,000. Rent is 26,000. Utilities, 20,000. Supply inventory, 20,000. Staff, of course, meron po kaming apat na staff. Ang sweldo po niya is 50,000. So we have one, this is very tricky. I want to also put your attention to this. One DMD is our dentist, which is actually Dr. Joy, no? Dr. Christine Joy. And she receives salary. Okay? She receives salary of that. Ang laki, no? And we have a DMD, of course. Bakit naman ang DMD? Napakaliit ng ano. Yan po ang associate namin. Because he's, pumapasok lang po siya 2 days. 2 days lang po. Okay? 2 days, 15,000? Oh, that's a very good business. So, ang all total expenses is 281,000 and nakita niyo na po. 500,000 is the sales and sorry. And 281,000 is the expenses. So, you have what we call wow, a profit growth of an annual gross income, Dr. Nick Nick, of around 2.268,000 pesos only for your one branch. Only for a specific branch. Can you imagine that? Ibig sabihin, pwede pala kayong kumita ng 5 million if you do have 2 branches already. And that is gross profit already. Ang babawasan lang po dito is tax. Okay? Because naisulat na po natin lahat ng expenses. If you will follow all of these things, if, of course, it's easier said than done. That's why we do have an alignment. We have a personal consultation. We have one-on-one discussion. I can also train your staff and give you a certain level of this particular target. And I can do that. Alright? So, pwede kumita ang dalawang clinic mo ng 5 million. And that is annual gross income. And that is not bad. No? So, pwede mo nang i-depend sa BIR that you do have your own bagong Fortuner. Hindi naman yung wala ka namang resibo, pero nakabagong Fortuner ka, saan ang galing yun? So also, we want to be able to protect your business at the same time. We want to be able to protect you as individual taxpayer. Now, that is about to change drastically and dramatically. Now that we are into this pandemic, I firmly believe that everybody's has been affected with this, but just to give you a brief overview of this particular research or study conducted by Asian Development Bank, after a disappointing 2019 growth in the region is expected to slow sharply to 2.2% in 2020 and under the effects of the current health emergency and rebound to 6.2% in 2021, excluding Asia's high income, newly industrialized economies growth will drop from 5.7 to 2.4 this year before recovering to 6.7% next year. Nako, ano ba itong research na ito? Hindi ko yata nindin yan. So, ganito lang po yan. If you are earning regularly in your dental clinic for 100,000 before this pandemic, there will be a slow growth. No? Hindi na po siya madadagdagan for 2019 up to 2020. 2.2 lang po. So, basically, kung 10,000 pesos, 2,000 pesos, 2,200 pesos tayong madadagdag. But, there's so much hope for the dentists out there. There's so much hope for all the my beloved dentists out there because there will be a next year, there will be a good recovery period of 6.7% next year. So, for example, kumikita ka ng 10,000, dadagdagan natin ng 6,700. Kumikita ka ng 100,000, we're going to add 6,700. Kumikita ka ng 10,000, we're going to add 670 pesos. And that is our regular monthly average and that is very high. Because the average, compound average growth lang po ng bawat business is 5.4. If you don't have an average of 6.7, still, dentistry is a good business. Tama po? No. It will drastically change. Why? Because today po, no, as of today, this is plus minus, there are around 4.5 million cases of COVID and around 320,000 deaths. So mag-ingat po tayo lahat. Next. So I just also would like to hear from all of the people or of the doctors who are watching right now, please comment your name. You can also comment where you are from. Maybe your greetings or hi. If you're learning a lot from these lectures, I would definitely appreciate. And give me more information. I will also will have an interaction later. I also would just like to show you that there are the workers who face the greatest coronavirus risk as of March 15. No, this is not even April period. Number one is doctors. Number two, personal aides. Number three, a nursing assistant, and even nurses. As you can see, doctors, 89% ang exposure to disease. But ang physical proximity is 97%. And that is doctors. Nakita nyo, apat lang po yan, no? Apat. I want to be able to show you the last one. And this is the last one. Doctora Ann Camus Padul, magandang gabi. Doctora Mitch, MD is watching also. Doctora Krista Joy Santos, magandang gabi po sa inyo lahat. Tingnan nyo po ito. You are my beloved dentist. And you exposed to diseases is 95%. And your physical proximity is 99%. Please stay safe. Okay? Dr. Annalie Gonzaga, stay safe. So, you are the most exposed in terms of exposure to disease. And also, you are the nearest in terms of physical proximity to patients. Especially, we don't know some of the exposure, no? So, now, I want to show you the three phases that you should realize, analyze, during, after ECQ and recovery. Okay? So, Dr. Robel Alcantara from Batangas, maraming salamat po sa inyo. Dr. Nick, Doku Netty, maraming salamat po sa pag-antabay sa inyo. So, this is the three phases that you should realize and analyze. Now, number one, first phase. So, this is today. Kung anong meron ka today, kung nasaan ka ngayon, this is today. Kung anong gagawin mo, pinawa mo kahapon, isama na natin sa today, hindi yesterday. Learn marketing and join webinars. Okay? So, the COVID-19 pandemic has triggered or rethink of online learning best practices. A lot of people now are into online services. Many have offered free webinars such as this. But this is more on direct to the point because I know the feeling because I run my clinic. I have a dentist. My wife is a dentist also. We do have clinics. We are all affected. And nakita nyo na po ang importance of continuing education. So whether you are at home, whether you're staying at home, you still need to have a continuing education. No? So a lot of webinars have been given to us by the Matter organization, and that is very, very good. And a lot of digital events are also being offered, but we are also going to offer you more learning. And the only good thing here for Dental Marketing Philippines is this is self-directed learnings, and we can issue you, no, after this pandemic na po, a certificate, no, for all of the lectures that you have attended. Okay? So that is another good news. So when you, ngayon po, medyo excuse pa yung PRC renewal, no, yung points, but definitely next year, it's still being revised, so it's still being deliberated in the Congress. So if you need more points, definitely self-directed learnings, we'll be able to issue you e-certificate, or we'll be able to issue you a physical certificate directly to your house or your clinic, and we will keep in touch. Next. So the COVID-19, the resulting shift in marketing trends, it clearly provides you an opportunity to let your audience know. Yan. So this is a great opportunity for each and every dentist who are listening to us right now. Meron po tayong assignment. Your assignment is to get to know not me, not your classmate, not your wife, but all of your businesses. No? Sino ba yung mga tao sa businesses? Particularly your audience, or particularly your patients. So this is a perfect opportunity for you to learn the behavior of your patients. How? We'll get to that. Focus more on brand building and run ads. So if you do, if you get the book of Dr. Kevin, now the Facebook branding, of course, you have to have logo, you have the vision, you have to have a mission. All of this information must be settled first before you can do the branding. Focus more on brand building and run ads that highlight your brand towards your targeted niche. Okay? Napag-usapan natin ng niche. There are niche for everybody, but you have to find the segmented market. No? Napag-usapan din po natin, I invited geriatric doctors from US, from Miami, Florida. that she is only practicing geriatric dentistry, and she's getting good amount of money. Okay, so and you do branding, no? And this is what we call professional branding. And if you have that branding, I'm pretty sure you're gonna have a great avenue of success, no? But now, so in learning and identifying your target market, so these are the things that you have to know. Okay, Doctora Ann Borromeo, Doctora Rosemary Katayna Orpilla, Doctora Katrin, Doctora Cora, Doctora Jer, Doctor, my poging Doctor Shelo Adahar, Doctor Eulalia Limbo, Doctor Fatima, Doctor Maria Elena, Doctor Rosel, Doctor Ariel again. Maraming salamat po sa pagtatabay niyo. So if you have identified your target market, now is the perfect time to know demographics, psychographic, geographic, sociographic, and behavioral. No, this is another lecture. Mahaba-haba po to. But what I'm trying to say is, you have to understand and you have to get to know where your patient is. Ano yung gusto nila? Sino sila ba talaga ang nagdedesisyon pag magpapatreat na? No? What is the right word to say to that? Closing techniques? Of course, that is another lecture. I do have 5 ways to close a technique. Closing techniques, because you are just also just a typical marketing man and salesman that you're also targeting and also closing a technique or closing a treatment. So basically, that is, we have option one, we have plan A, plan B, and plan C in closing treatment. So these are the things that we have to learn also in creating a complete marketing package. So you have to target market what you can do, and probably you try searching, because your patient is searching you, try search several target market or several groups that potentially would be your market. Next, there are 4 kinds of dental marketing for business. I'm pretty sure you have done traditional. I'm pretty sure you have done internal. Alam ko po, you've also done external community marketing. But this, today, you cannot go out. You are in ECQ. Some other are GCQ, of course. You need to have an internet. And this is what we call the triangle of technology. Okay? Now, kaya po, kailangan natin to. Bago tayo magsimula dito, make your dental clinic stand out in a noisy dental world. Huwag po kayong mag-alala, Dr. Ronald Policarpio, maraming salamat po. Good evening, sir. Perfect learning and encouragement to all of us. Don't worry. We do have a lot of clients. We do have a lot of market. And we have patience enough for everybody. But while you are doing this, while we are in this ECQ, you have to be noisy. Huh? Your clinic must be able to project what is the branding. Okay? So again, start with your logo. It starts with your vision. It starts with your mission. And once you've established all of this trust, it's the perfect opportunity for you to be noisy. Huh? You cannot go out and be noisy in the bus station. You cannot go out and be noisy at the mall. You can just go and noisy with the social media platform. And the social media platform, and siguro naman po, Dr. Aurora, Dr. Jasmine, Dr. Antonio, alam niyo na kung saan ang pinaka-traffic na social media platform. But I wanna just give you one more avenue. So of course, you're gonna say, alam mo na, Facebook. Yes, Facebook. Still, whether you like it or not, it's going to be a good a platform for your branding. But I want to share with you the one particular platform is the Instagram. Okay, Instagram is also very good. And the good thing here is you can still connect. You can connect Instagram to Facebook. No? Isa swipe mo lang connected na. Once you post it to Instagram, it will automatically posted in Facebook. But the before and after will not be accepted in Facebook. So you should post it in the Instagram, so it will automatically download it in Facebook. So that's how you do it, right? Now let's proceed. So you have to remember that number one, patient's loyalty is essential. Okay, marami, you do have a lot of patients, so definitely you do have a lot of patients who are not loyal, but probably 95% of your patients loyal to you. Whether you are in Quezon City, they will still give ride two buses or two jeeps just to go and get to your clinic. That's how loyal is your patients to you. But there is a problem today. We do have perfect concerns today. And patients are no exceptions. They won't want to connect to their dentist right away. And as a business owner, kayo po, no? Dr. James and Piwi, Dr. Ellen Kaidik, Dr. Malu, you are a business owner. And your responsibility doesn't end inside your clinic. Your responsibility today is to connect with them. Okay? How do Sir Roche, daming kong pasyente, 3,000. Of course, you cannot connect with 3,000. Probably you can connect with 100. No. So there is also a segmentation process that your secretary must do inside your clinic and connect with your patients. Now, I'm going to show you some of the techniques on how to do that. Let's proceed. Number two, now is the time to adjust and take actions. Okay? Implement and build some dental digital marketing campaign. Now, napag-aralan nyo na yan. And service your patients online because they want to be able to give them, patients would want to hear you. Patients would want to feel you. And patients would want to just chit-chat and then get consultations from you. And that is a big avenue for success. Online and in any other new norms, you do teledentistry. You do digital consultations. And when you do digital consultations, definitely, they will be more loyal to you. And when they are loyal to you, they cannot be taken away by any other source, even the corporate dentistry. Okay? Next. Number three. Baka busy-busy kayo sa panonood ng news o pag-aayos ng mga bahay nyo. Get your house in order. When I talk about house, this is your clinic. Go to your clinic, disinfect, go to your clinic, rearrange, go to your clinic, move everything that is, take out everything that you don't need anymore at this pandemic. No? Itago nyo muna, uwi nyo sa bahay, get your house in order. Okay? And number four, naku, tuwan-tuwa na mga dentista, tuwan-tuwa na, ECQ, GCQ. Number four is the strategy today. We are not talking about the liftment of ECQ yet. We are talking today. What you can do today is pre-book your patients. Okay? When will be the next appointment? Work down the list of your patients. Call your secretary. Ask them to go with you in the clinic. Sort all of the patients that have been postponed. Sort all of the patients that needs to go back after 6 months. Now it's just, we've spent probably 3 months. Perfect opportunity for just 1 month patients. Pre-book all of them. Goodwill will make them more loyal. And you can now pre-book them. Okay? So if they hear from you, if they hear from their dentist, they will feel that their dentist cares. And that is so important. Then you can plan their next visit. Okay? So you can now pre-book them. So when we, of course, we are anticipating that after a month, it will be done. It will be finished. It will be lifted. So you can pre-book them, of course, with the proper equipment. Okay? All right. Dr. Balot, Dr. Lina, Dr. Lily Kwan, Dr. Bells from Marinduque, maraming salamat po sa pag-antabay. Thank you very much. Now, let us talk to the second phase. So when we are done with ECQ, after ECQ, yan, ito na, excited na kayo. Implement the plan. Get back to work. Slowly. I wanna give you the word slowly or don't rush. Okay? Importance of implementing the plan and getting back to work is slowly. No? Don't rush back and said to the public, we're reopening, we're open. Okay, come here, COVID patients or symptomatic patients, come in. No. Try to assess. And get all of the things that you have learned from all of the scientific lectures, from all the protocols, from your mother organizations, and get back there and learn all of the objectives. When you're going to open the clinic, are you ready? Are you equipped? No. This short or probably an extension setback will give you an opportunity to reassess if you're going to reopen or not. Okay? Why? Because of this. Can you help me read, Dr. Rebecca, Dr. Noemi? Are your patients lying to you? Sadly, yes. It is 25% of your patient lies to you. At marami pong dentista sa ibang bansa, specifically sa China and sa Bangkok, Thailand. Because the patient did not tell the right, the real, and the correct history, they were tested positive in COVID. Okay? So this has been scientifically proven that 25% or probably after this pandemic, maybe tataas pa dito, that really are telling a lie. So we have to really secure proper questionnaire. Now, we'll discuss that later po. I'm going to give you just a sample and I'm just going to give you also the protocol inside our new clinic, the new norms in our dental practice. Okay? So let's proceed. Why do you need to slow down? So just like what Dr. Noemi says from Batangas, probably this is the sixth lecture that I had. I was in Batangas City during Dr. Noemi's term and I'm very thankful to her. Most of the procedures produce aerosols. Okay, pagbukas pa lang nabibig, lalabas na. Some patients, COVID-19, positive, is asymptomatic. That is a very dangerous word. And clinic mostly are not equipped with intraoral evacuators, extraoral aerosol suctions, disinfectants, UV lights, autoclaves, and most especially PPEs. And also, we never know what will happen after nag-open siya ng May 31 to June of practice. That's why it's very important for all of you, dear dentists, my beloved dentists, to go back slowly and assess. Don't rush. Okay? Nabasa ko po ito. No? Remember, the fundamental law of protection. Consider everybody around you as a symptomatic carrier of COVID-19 and capable of infecting you. Consider too that you yourself could be an asymptomatic carrier of COVID-19 capable of infecting all around you. So train yourself by using all your intelligence to neither get infected nor infect others, right? So this is something that we have to look forward to. So this is something that we all must be in our mind, okay? So let's talk about phase 3, no? So phase 3 na po tayo, mga minamahal kong dentista. At maraming salamat po sa pag-antabay, Fatima, Jesusa, Dr. Agoy, Dr. Rem. Thank you very much. Recovery. So recovery period, be patient. No? Alam ko pong talaga kayong gigil nang bumalik sa inyong practice, pero isa lang po ang sinasabi ko, maging pasensyoso, huwag madaling kumita ng pera kaagad, but you have to stay focused and have a fresh graduate mentality, you know? Later on, I'm gonna discuss, ano ba yung fresh graduate mentality, you know? Sa mga fresh graduate, siguro tuwa-tuwa na, you know? Kasi ginamit ko sila, fresh graduate mentality. Stay focused, you know? Why do I say stay focused? Because a lot of dentists, ang dami ko na narinig, ang dami ko na nakita, ang dami ko na nabasa. I wanna put other businesses na nga because wala yatang lang kasunod yata itong dentists ito. Hindi na yata kami babalik sa traction namin. You are wrong. Dear dentist, you are still in the right track. Okay? I love you still. You're gonna get back to work and you're gonna have what we call a very fresh recovered period. And you're going to be thanking this particular slide. I'm pretty sure you're going to be good. Rest assured that. Okay? Stay focused. So, nakita ko kay Dr. Dairy dito eh. 1900, ganito po. No, 1950, ganito. 2000, ganito. 2020, ganito. What this picture tells us is we have to prepare every 10 years. Or probably, oh, this one, 20 years. We have to prepare for 20 years. With any other pandemic that will happen. So we have to be prepared. Next, a lot of people, sabi po ng ibang dentist na, no patient, no income, no consultations, no work, no pay. That's why some dentists, you are looking for some other business. Some dentists are also negative. Trying to be anxiety starting to come in. So this is not healthy also. No? Nakakatakot po ito. No? Pero, huwag po kayong mag-alala, we're gonna get there. You're gonna get through this pandemic. Okay? Next. Change your mind. Change your mindset. It's all in the mind. Within every dentist lies a great business person. Ulitin po natin. No? So, Dr. Carmina, magandang araw po sa panonood. Dr. Catherine, sa mga nanonood po, just shout out. Bumati po kayo, pakita nyo po kung taga saan kayo, babanggitin ko po ang pangalan nyo, pero gusto ko lang po sabihin sa inyo, mga kaibigan, mga kapatid, mga kliyente, or kaibigan at katoto, mga colleagues, within every dentist lies a great business person. Hindi nyo lang po alam, hindi lang po siguro natitrigger, ngayon, ititrigger ko na. Mag-isip, magplano, isulat sa papel at ballpen kung ano ang gusto mong mangyari. After 5 years, isulat mo, ipakita mo sa akin, i-assess natin, and you're gonna get there. You're gonna be a successful dentist, no? In terms of practice, profession, and in terms of business and clinic. Okay? Maraming salamat. It will be okay. Okay? It will definitely be okay. Dr. Audrey, Dr. Yonel Torres, Dr. Larry, magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Definitely, you will be okay. Some positive habits that will take you through these trying times. Oh, itry po natin ito, no? Number one, find optimistic viewpoint in negative situation. Okay? So, self-practice na lang yan, ha? Focus on what you can control. Huwag niyo pong isipin yung sinasabi ng ibang tao. You just focus on what you can control because everything that you can control, you can measure. You cannot measure what you cannot. So focus on doing so, right? If you can control your dental practice, if you can control the clinic, all the furniture's there, and all the thinking that you have in mind, just do it. Invest in uplifting or learning. Set a personal schedule and goals. Even if we are in this pandemic, you set up a goals tomorrow morning, lunch, evening, so that you'll be busy. So the next time that you get, so when we open up and we go to the practice, you have also your goals every time that you go to your dental practice. Okay? Remember that people are still working to make it better. So, meron po mga nag-aaral na scientist, magkakaroon po tayo ng vaccine, konting panahon lang, huwag kayong mag-alala. Okay? Salamat po sa inyo lahat. And, why am I saying that you should have a fresh graduate mentality? Bakit? Nung nag-graduate po kayo, di ba, excited na excited kayo? Lahat kayo excited? All that fresh graduate, yun siyempre yung pasado, board passer, ano? Hindi lang yung graduate kasi hindi pa graduate, hindi pa PRC license. So pagka nagka-license na kayo, ready na kayo, no? Makautang na kaya kay mama, makautang na kaya kay papa. So you are excited. So these are the things that we have to have in mind, no? Kahit mga mature dentist na kayo, ang mga fresh graduate hindi rin masyadong na-stress dati, no? Nang pagka gusto na mag-practice, and fresh graduate is also so patient. They do have a lot of patience in their mind and in their heart. And also, on the other picture on the left, on the right side, you see that they can also do multitasking. So we have to have this kind of mindset, the fresh graduate mentality. Tama po, Dr. Arceli, Dr. Ogi, Dr. Manalo, Dr. Ruth, Dr. Shirba, Dr. Tets, magandang hapon, magandang gabi, Dr. Tets, Carrera Rubico from San Pedro, Dr. Imelda Cabalsa from Davao, Dr. Princess Mabagos, maraming salamat po. This is not a motivation, inspirational. Opo, this is reality. Kayang-kaya niya yan. Makakabalik kayo. Huwag kayong mag-alala. Dr. Princess. Dr. Lourdes, of course, magandang gabi from Quezon City. Dr. Arlene from Las Piñas. No, kapitbahay. Dr. Joey Cristobal. Dr. Joy Cristobal. Of course, you're a great doctor, Dr. Joy Cristobal. Next. So, we'll have a little break now. We'll have a little break because I want you to join our Pasaya. So ito po yung sinasabi natin, register now and you will win amazing prizes, no? So all you have to do, no, makikita nyo po dyan, may link dyan, https://bit.ly/dmppasaya. So this is dental marketing brought to you by really me and Kevin. We're really helping you to get back into sales traction. So if you register, you will have an opportunity to win. No? Isa-isay na po natin, no? Ang title po ng aming webinar na webinar Pasaya ito is Kwentong Dental, Kwentang Pasaya, Kwentong Pasaya para sa Filipino Dentist. Number one, you'll have an opportunity to get 50% ng po, discount, 50% discount sa aking libro. So this is a 158 pages book and this will be released probably August na po. And you will also receive or have a chance to win BlanQuest Home Whitening Kit. This is worth 8,000 each. So, pwede nyo pong ipamigay, ibenta ka agad, no? Bigyan yung promo ang inyong pasyente, so, para may kita kayo agad, no? So, 8,000 po ito, pamimigay po namin dalawa, galing po yan sa KGR Dental Center. So, pwede nyo i-treat sila, ibenta sa kanila ng 4,000, o 4,000, discounted na 50%. Plus, meron din po tayong pamimigay na SDF, no? Silver Diamond Fluoride. So, this is good for 300 surface, this is worth 3,500, para sa inyo din po yan. So, nakikita niyo po yung model sa baba. Magmimigay din po tayo ng isa, dalawang PPE. So, ang PPE po natin is WBL, or white back lining, or silver back lining. Dalawa po yan. Worth 1,000 po isa niyan. And, dami naman itong pa-premium nito, Dr. Kevin. No. So, we have also 3M, SPE, Simple Tooth Cream. No? So, dalawa yata ang piraso yan. Mahal din po yan. Then, meron din tayong Prolaxan. Aba, daming Prolaxan. This is a probiotic tablet. Binibigay po natin. So, ang presyo po niya sa mga pasyente is 2,500. Libre po. Dalawa po ang pamimigay natin niya. So, this is worth 5,000. Plus, of course, you can get a lot of Facebook attraction marketing na libro para sa inyo po lahat yan. Meron din tayong tips yung libro. Pamimigay din natin yan. At meron din tayong Ensumo disinfectant, which is definitely needed in your clinic. So, I think we're going to raffle up probably dalawa or na Ensumo para sa mga dentista. So with that, meron pong registration yan. Papakita po ni Dr. Kevin ang link. I-press nyo lang po yan. Magkakaroon po kayo ng opportunity to win all of these prizes. And ang kagandahan nito, May 15, live po yan. Live raffle. Makakasama po natin dyan doon. Other than Dr. Romeo and Jacob. So we'll have a break for 1 minute. 1 minute lang po ang break natin at iinom lang ng tubig ang inyong presenter. So while you're registering, probably we'll give you 1 minute. So that I can also rest. Okay, so babalik po tayo in 1 minute. Maraming salamat po. Bigyan mo lang 60 seconds o 15 na lang po. Babalik po tayo. Maraming salamat po.
I'm a man who doesn't know how to fail. A contradiction, you come and go, you come and go.
Hello, magandang gabi. We're back. So, maraming salamat po sa inyong pananatili. We're not done. So, basically, we have discussed the new norms. We basically discussed everything that you can learn from this pandemic. And as a founder of Dental Marketing Philippines, gives out lectures, seminars. So, we align and provide the right and effective way to do segmentation, market niching, alignment for your clinic. And also, I'd like to give you the dental marketing roadmap and action plan to survive and to earn money today and tomorrow. So ito po, for learning and future lectures for your chapters. So I'll be happy to be in your chapters. You can always reach me at this email, ehcor_r@yahoo.com. And you can always message me at 0908-881-8809. So again, we proceed with the new norms. Okay, so we'll wait for them. Okay, so maraming salamat po. Now, we are back. So I'm gonna show you our new norms. So we will discuss briefly our new setup of step-by-step flow in accepting patients. So pwede po ito, pwede nyo po itong copyhin, pwede nyo picturean, and you can edit. So this is just a guide inside clinic protocol on accepting patients from initial contact to the exit. So this is a great avenue also for you to learn. Number one, what can a dentist do today? So information and guidelines from your PDA and of course with the DOH. But of course, I will not be touching on this. So as you can see, this is the first time that you have seen this figure, this illustration, probably April 10. I was able to discuss these things also. And let us proceed. Number one, please wear your face mask. So, sa pintuan nyo pa lang po, sa dental clinic, meron po tayo dapat na ilagay na, please wear your face mask. Okay? So, you can take your own photos. Huwag po kayong, as much as possible, we wanted to for you to print your own picture. We want to create an avenue that it will be your picture. So, there will be a real branding on that. Number one, step by step. Number one, disinfection. Alcohol, mouthwash, hair cover, and temperature and blood pressure check. So, we have so many viewers. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. At we are very fortunate. You are also very fortunate that we really wanted to share this as we await for more people who are actually trying to win prizes. Kaya talaga mga dentists. So, para po tayo nasa seminar. Para po tayo nasa dental chapter next year, no? May pa-premyo, may registration, but you do have a lot of learnings. Actually, mahigit isang oras na pala ako. So, isang lecture na ito. So, pangalawang lecture na po itong topic ko. So, there will be second lecturer, but one lecturer. Ako po yan. So, Roche Ruiz, thank you very much, Dr. Leonie, Dr. Nieva. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. So, as pinakita po ni Dr. Kevin yung kung paano kami mag-register, it's time for you to get back to this presentation. Number one, disinfection. So, sinasabi ko po, sa step one pa lang, sa pintuan pa lang, may wear your face mask. So, pag pasok sa clinic, number one, disinfection and temperature and blood pressure check. What? May blood pressure check? Opo, yan. So, panoorin niyo po, ha? So, I'll proceed. Our reception will have acrylic barrier. Okay, sa reception na po, syempre may dapat may acrylic barrier. Kung syempre, ang iba po walang acrylic barrier, plastic lang po muna. Okay. Okay, thank you Dr. Irene. We'll have alcohol for patients. So, pagpasa pa lang ng patient, check alcohol. We'll have less furniture. Konti na lang po ang furniture natin. Okay? Nagbawas po tayo ng dalawang malaking couch. We'll have DAS. Okay, ano ba yung DAS? So this is disinfectant aerosol sprayer. We'll have UV light disinfectant control, no? Pwedeng malaki, pwedeng maliit po, okay? We'll have scented air humidifier para naman mabango po yung dental clinic natin. Okay? So, next. So yun po yung makikita niyo sa reception. Sana po na picturean niyo to. Babalikan ko, picturean niyo, no? Eh kasi yung iba nagre-register pa. So step 1, please wear face mask. Step 2, sa pinto, please wear face mask. Sa pangalawa, step by step, disinfection. Pangatlo, ito po yung nakalagay sa reception namin. Okay? Now, our patient, ano man po ang gagawin natin sa mga patient, ganun pa rin po ang sitwasyon natin, will be disinfected via alcohol, mouthwash, temperature check, and blood pressure check following secretary's instruction on what will be the next move. Why? Because early studies shows that people with novel coronavirus is actually based on Lancet. Ito po yung medical journal ng, of course, ng mga doctors. We have seen so far about 1/4 to half of the COVID-19 patients who had to be admitted. There is high blood pressure. Okay? So, pag medyo mataas ang high blood pressure, alam niyo na po ang ginagawa niyo. It's either kukuha kayo ng medical certificate or pahihintayin niyo na. Pero in this situation, sa ating pong pagkakataon na ito, pag nag-clinic na kayo, pag may high blood pressure, labas na muna. Okay? Pasta po muna. Ibig sabihin, temperature check, okay naman, lahat na. Pero may high blood pressure, balik na lang po kayo, we will schedule you na next time. Okay? Kasi may high blood pressure. So that is 25% to 50%. So dangerous. So those are the things that we have to know. Step 2, So, step 2 na po tayo. Answer the questionnaire. Again, for those who are watching, Dr. Irene, Dr. Eva, Dr. Nieva, thank you very much po. But again, you can message us, shout out, you can tell us where you are from so that we can mention your name, Dr. Cecil Medina. So, ang step 2 po sa dental practice namin is answer the questionnaire. And make sure, tandaan niyo po ito ha, to confirm it with their signature. Very, 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 very important that you must secure their signature for every form that they will sign. So, next, still, nasa reception pa lang po ha, hindi pa po gumagalaw ang ating pasyente, she should stay there or he should stay there. Secretary will provide 2 kinds of questionnaires. Number 1 is the standard questionnaire. Alam niyo na po yan. No? Yan. So, standard questionnaire, yung kadalasan yung ginagamit. So, kung hindi kayo gumagamit noon, gumamit na kayo. Number 2 is post-COVID-19 questionnaire. So, post-COVID-19 questionnaire, if you don't have this one yet, I'll just message us for your email, then we will be sending it to you. Or also, you can post your message to Dental Marketing Philippines page, then we will send it to you. Or we will post it right away kasi meron po siyang PDF file or meron din siyang Word that you can edit and you can put your logo on. Okay? So next, Dr. Ginebert Javier from Makati. Maraming salamat po. Dr. Jasmine, Dr. Elsa. And signature is very important. Plus, kaya ako po kayo pinapanood, still in our reception, this is very important. There is a reiteration of consultation fee. Yan. Sa mga wala pong consultation fee, marami pong salamat at nakikinig kayo. So, I think this is a perfect opportunity for us to start. And perfect opportunity for you to start. The reiteration of consultation fee. Ang pagsabi po ng consultation fee, meron pong tinatawag na strategy. Okay? Ang strategy po, hindi po sinasabi, ay, pasyente, meron na kaming consultation fee ha? 500. Ay, pasyente, meron na kaming consultation fee ha? 300. So, hindi po ganon. It's a mindsetting. It's a mindsetting thing. Alright? So, still in the reception, doon po sa kanyang sinasagot ang questionnaire, meron na po doong diskarte na pag sa puso at sa isip na meron po tayong standard na consultation fee. Okay? Pero nakalagay din po doon, meron pong disclaimer doon. You can have it for free pag natuloy ang treatment. Pag hindi, may bayad. Okay? So, ganun po ang diskarte. Ha? Hindi po kasi pwedeng, may consultation fee na kami eh. Pasyente, may consultation fee na kami. Naku po, lalabas at lalabas ka agad yun. Huwag pong ganun. Okay? Sige, pwede ko po yung turuhan ng step by step on how to close it. Because, having said that, that is also very important for your practice, for your growth practice. Alright? Sige po. O, picturean niyo po. Pwede niyo pong gayahin niya. Wala pong problema sa akin niya. Okay? So, step 3 na po tayo. No sound. Do I need to register? Doc, need din po ang pulse oximeter sa reception area. Sa Dr. Elizabeth Mendoza, there are a lot of dentists also like to use the proximeter just to get the oxygen level. That is also very, that is an option, but it will take another probably a few more minutes to get the oxygen level, probably 1 or 2 minutes. Yeah, pwede rin po yan, pwede rin po. That is another investment that you can do. But temperature check and blood pressure check is the SOP standard, so pwede na rin yan. Okay? So, Dr. Piche, wala, may sounds, pakisabi lang po, Dr. Amy, Dr. Rochelle, Dr. Piche, may sound po ba? Malinaw? Is it clear? I'm coming so clearly? Yeah, if somebody will say it's clear, I will proceed. If not, I will rearrange this first. Okay? Can somebody tell me if I'm coming so clearly? Humina sounds mo, Sir Roche. Yo, humina. Okay, we'll make it. Nagkaano po ako? Yan. Okay na po. Ayan. Okay. So, we are in the step number 3. Proceed to the treatment room. So, once patients are done with the first step, dami na pong nagawa sa first step, ha? Sa second step, sa third step na po tayo. Proceed to the treatment room. Okay? So, bago po nagpunta sa treatment room, shoe cover. So, dito pa lang po namin bibigyan siya ng shoe cover. Ganito po ang diskarte. Nung iba po kasi may mat sa labas. Pero that is gonna be so messy. Not unless you provide a stamp inside again that will dry their stamp pad. But that is also an option, no? If you're going to do that, okay lang po. But sa amin, before go, sa reception po, kasi every day, every other patient or every hour, pagmamap po ng mga disinfectant, no? Aside from the aerosol sprayer. So, bago po siya mag-proceed the treatment room, kasama na po sa pagbibigay ng aming secretary or assistant yung shoe cover. So, all of the individual, whether you are dentist or patient or even dadaan ka lang doon, you have to have a shoe cover. It will be provided for the dentist. And wait for the dentist. And again, no companion, mga kaibigan. So, treatment room, assistant or secretary will provide shoe cover to the patient. No companions will be allowed. And the treatment room is also isolated with a 0.22 gauge of plastic covering. Now, if you wanted to have a complete closure, you can do so, but we are just trying to show you what we are going to do in our practice. Okay? And patient will be assisted to the 3R. Okay? Hindi po pwedeng walang assistant na mag-guide sa pasyente. Baka mali ko, mahawakan ito. Ano po? So, just straight to the treatment area. Okay? Next, inside the treatment room naman, we have our dental equipment to help protect us and our patients. Number one, ito po, papakita ko po, meron kaming aerosol suction machine. Kung meron ka ng high volume evacuator na dental chair, meron po kasing ibang dental chair na may high volume evacuator na. Ang kailangan mo lang dun po, hindi mo na kailangan ng intraoral. Ang kailangan mo lang ay yung aerosol suction machine. Pero kung wala ka naman po, I think you need to have a portable, no? So, depende po. Meron namang malaki that it can suck 2 to 3 chairs, and tawag po natin doon ay central vacuum system. So, chairs are always sanitized, every patient, and we have Insumo disinfectant are being sprayed every 4 hours. Okay? So, which is which? Although we have, ito po ang sinasabi ko lang, no? Which is which? Although we have a complete setup before we open up by June or July, we believe that no amount of devices or equipment can protect us from the virus. So, kagaya po na lagi ko sinasabi, we still have to be, to go back slowly, we have to assess, and no rush, really try to determine the situation that is happening around the community. No? Now, let's proceed with step number 4. Okay, ang dami po nag-comment ng clear. Now, maraming pong salamat. Maraming pong salamat sa mga pagtitiwala. Now, Maureen, Nang San Perez, Dr. Ronald, Dr. J, Dr. Lani Jose, yeah, Dr. Rona, Dr. Catalina, Dr. Arcel, Dr. Lourdes, Dr. Noel, Dr. Amanda, Dr. Nick, Dr. Elsa, Dr. Marcel, Dr. Ems, Dr. Annalie, Dr. Cheryl, Dr. May, Dr. Cora, Dr. Jasmine, Dr. Ogi, Dr. Nieva, Dr. Ellen, Dr. Dick. Okay, Dr. Magat. Now, let's proceed with step number 4. This is a discussion of treatment plan. Casual interview may be done, of course. Sinagutan niya na yung mga questionnaire. Dalawang questionnaire, ha? Tandaan niyo. Dalawang questionnaire po yung sinagot niya. Tapos may interpretation of mayroong mind procedural in terms of consultation fee. Tapos meron po tayong tinatawag na casual interview. Pero bago pumasok ang dentista noon, na-analyze niya na kung anong pinagsasagot po ng pasyente. And procedure starts. Now, dentist to patient. Dentist explains based on perspective. Ito, there's another closing technique, no? Another topic po yon. Baka may bayad yan. Joke lang po. So, this is another technique. So, dentist explains on perspective the treatment plan and procedure may start. Okay? So, there's also 5 ways to close a deal. So, I'm pretty sure a lot of dentists knows how to close a deal, but this is also a great avenue for you to learn. So, pag na-convince nyo, then the procedure may start. Correct? I'll proceed. Now, step number 5. Post-treatment consultations, when the treatment is done, prescription and reminders, and scheduling for the next patient's visit. Okay? So, ano po ba ito? Dentist will provide last few instructions to the patient. Secretary will give the patient his or next visit schedule, of course, upon the advice of the dentist. And patients will remove, this is very important, patients will remove shoe cover, hair cover, and direct it to the laundry bin located near the exit of your dental clinic. Okay? So, mag-providing kayo ng laundry bin na may takip. Kung yung laundry bin nyo po, merong plastic, yung garbage bag na itim. Naka-cover po yung garbage bag. Every time na may mga mask or covers, isasarado niyo po. Tapos tatakbuhan. Okay? That is what we call the laundry bin. Okay? So meron po tayo niyan. Now, what are the necessary precautionary measures do I and my staff have to do in order for us to feel and be safe? All dental staff must wear PPEs. Dentists will have to have at least 10 PPEs, set of PPEs. Dami naman do. Dami naman yan, Sir Roche. 10 sets of PPEs. Dalawa lang nga nabili ko. Kulang po yan. Bili po kayo. Okay? Dapat po WBL or SBL. Okay? So, ang design po talaga, no, is disposable po naman talaga lahat. Pero, of course, disposable po. Medyo mahal. So, recommendable is yung medical grade na autoclaveable. One patient, one PPE. Opo, narinig niyo po, tama, one patient, one PPE. Sa mga nagtitipid, after one patient, disinfect niyo na po, sprayan niyo na lang. Pwede rin siguro yan, pero of course, we don't recommend and we're not going to do that in the clinic. And the dentist will not bring the PPEs home. Bawal pong iuwi. Aba, paano gagawin dyan? E di lalagay niyo sa plastic at palalabahan niyo sa laundry, ano, sa sa mga nagpapalaundry. And laundry bin in the clinic, this is a new norm. Okay? So, from Rizal Dental Chapter, Dr. Ellen, thank you very much. I did the presentation there. So, standard personal protection, all should be disposable. This is the standard. And gloves, hairnet to cover, no face shield, no practice. We have 3-ply mask, goggles, PPE, medical grade. One PPE, good for 6 to 12 months. Microfiber PPE, good for 3 to 6 months. After use, put that into your clinic's covered laundry bin. Now, so those are the things that you need for PPEs, and those are the things that we're going to do, and that is the step-by-step new norms of our dental practice. Okay po ba? Maraming pong salamat sa mga nanonood. At ito naman po ang pinaka... I will proceed with this topic. Kano? How much? No? Sumasawa na kayo sa HM. Ano? How much? Got so much, how much? Kano? Now it's the time for you to answer. Kano is a short for the word magkano. The term used is for asking how much is the needed payment. Yan. Kayo naman po ang magtanong. But we have a question here. What is the best way to tell the patient why we have to charge extra? Because if before we charged 350 for consultation and now we have to add 500 minimum, so a total of 850. Wow! Actually, what's the best word? Infection control fee or any suggestion? Dr. Arnel, if you're charging before at 350 pesos for consultation, I think that is perfectly fine. If you want to go 500, that is also perfectly fine. But in our case, in our dental, just to give you a brief overview, before pandemic, we are charging 350 in our dental tourism clinic. We are charging 250 or free for our Las Piñas community clinic. But if they will proceed with dental treatment, we are not going to charge any single centavo for that consultation fee. So that's how our service. But again, you dentist, you do have, meron po kayong sinumpaan that you can provide, you will provide ethical service to all the patients. So you can give it for free. That is your choice. Okay? So this is the standard. Your clinic must have a standard. But you, as in the service industry, it is your right to give it for free. But your clinic is not free. Something like that. Okay? So we have a way to do that. So, but for me po, if you're going to ask me 850 consultation fee, that's too much. Okay? So we're going to have a discussion on that. And I'm going to proceed with KANO. Ito na po yung last part of our presentation. Okay? Next. Yeah, si Dr. Leo daw, called it asepsis charge. Parang nakakatakot naman yung salita niya. Dr. Ramonina from Mandaluyong, maraming salamat. I hope I could be able to do a lecture there and I'll be happy to share with you all the wisdoms. No? But I don't want to lecture for 1 hour. I want 1 hour and 30 minutes para mas malaking bayad. Okay, next. Are you ready? If I'm going to ask the dentists who are watching me right now, are you ready to know the KANO? No? But there's a disclaimer. This will involve a little bit of math, which is your favorite topic, right? Okay. So we'll get back to that. I think 850, 500, medyo, I don't see it coming. But let's see. So are you ready to know? This will involve a little bit of math. I'll proceed now. So again, if you have not registered, register there. DMP Masaya, you have an opportunity to win several prizes. Look into your professional life cycle. Okay? So, when we talk about infection control fee, asepsis fee, consultation fee, hindi basta-basta. Hindi po di-discard na, oh, may bayad ng consultation fee, ito pong bayad. Oh, you will lose your patients. I'm telling you, you will lose a lot of patients. Okay? And definitely, this is not the right way to do strategies. Kaya nga po, we are here to help you out. We are here, dental marketing, to provide you the proper guidance in convincing your patients to pay consultation fee. And some other patients, they cannot even pay the 350 or 500 pesos or even 800 pesos prophylaxis or filling. Then you're gonna charge them 500 or you're gonna charge them 850. Good luck. I'm just being practical. I'm just telling you the truth. There's always truth to this matter. There's always a way to do it. And we can do it professionally. We cannot just go back to the practice and abruptly say that we have a charge of 500 pesos or 850 for asepsis fee, for consultation fee. That is not the right way to do. It is a must for us to have a consultation fee. It is a must for us to have this kind of additional fee. But there will always be 100 ways to close in terms of closing techniques for all the patients. Even a single centavo is an additional burden to your patients. Okay? So tatandaan po natin yan. I know that you have spent a lot, but just all be, what we can do is just be ethical. Okay? Dr. Loslen, paano mag-register, Dr. Loslen? All you have to do, just go to the link. It will be provided by Dr. Kevin in the message kanina. Okay? Now, let's proceed. Are you ready for the presentation that involves math? Doctora, okay? So, eto po, are you ready to know does it involve a little bit of math and for you to be able to register, bit.ly, DMP Pasaya. Yan, pasok lang po kayo, Doctora Wilma. And, now, this is what I want to tell you. Your professional life cycle. There are 220 days of practice at 3 patients per day because you can only see patients, 3 patients per day now in this current situation. So, we are going to get a simple computation, introduction, growth, maturity, and saturation. Meron po yung tinatawag na idea, meron po yung tinatawag na decline sa professional dental practice life cycle. Pero that is another topic again. Okay. Now, bakit naman si Roche 220 days yan? Because during the study research that I did, dental clinic or you do dentist are only practicing on a regular yearly average of 220 days practice. Okay? If you want to get to know more of this, we'll have another one in professional life cycle topic. Okay? Now, introduction. If you're on the stage of introduction, alam niyo naman po ito, 3 to 5 years practice, you are in the process, you are still in the introduction period. Growth, so times 2. Maturity, times 3. Okay? So, Dr. Elsa, Dr. Veronica. So, if the first thing that you should realize is, nasaan ka na? Where are you? Are you in the matured practice? Are you in the saturation practice? Decline practice? Idea practice? Introduction? Growth? There are 6 cycles. Pero ito lang po yung nilagay ko yung standard, na may actual fee na standard. Huh? Hindi po siya pababa, hindi po siya na zero. Okay? Kasi yung idea, zero. Yung decline, pababa na eh. So we start we just take into consideration introduction, growth, maturity. First thing that you should do is try to identify where you are. If you're able to identify introduction, probably 3 years in the practice, you are still there. Don't rush going into the growth and maturity period. Okay? Now, sample computation. This is on a per case-to-case basis based on the things that we should do in the clinic. And I think number 1, alcohol per station. Alcohol is 500 for 500 ml. That is for 1,000 times. That is 40 cents lang po. Ganun lang po ang presyo niya. Hindi po porke bumili ka ng 400, i-charge mo sa pasyente mo. Mouthwash. Of course, you do have a mouthwash. They have to gargle before going to the patient. 150 divided by 20 patients, 750 pesos lang po yan. Hair cover, 250, 50 pesos, 5 piso lang po yan. Shoe cover is the patient. So, these are all the expenses of the patients. Nakikita mo yung expenses ng dentist, so expenses ng clinic. So, iniba-iba ko po. Dentist, patient, and clinic. But of course, we're going to automatically add all of that later. Gloves. So, gloves, nako, napakamahal na po ng gloves. 8 pesos na per piece. Ply mask, or 16 pesos na per piece. 800 pesos. And in sumo disinfectant, that is probably 1.7 lang po per spray. So, that 850 is good for 3 to 6 months. So, that's very good. Now, nakuha niyo po. You can take a picture. You can have it. No problem for me. PPE is for staff. Ang staff po may PPE din. Ang dentist po may PPE din. Alam niyo yung presyo ng PPE ng staff is 5 piso lang po yan per patient. Okay, 5 piso lang po because you can use that for 6 months. So, that's 120 days. Okay? Straight na po yun. You can even extend to 7 or 8. Okay. PPE for dentist, it's 7 pesos. Plastic cover. Yung plastic cover na binili mo, sisira po yan ng 3 buwan. Acrylic barrier, probably after 2 years or 0. So, face shield is 180 patient divided. So, that's 3.61. And goggles, 300 pesos, 2 years, 0.42. So, this is how you compute your additionals. You're not going to compute. If you buy goggles for 100, you're going to charge for 4 patients 50 pesos each. That's unfair. Unfair sa patients. We are all consumers also. We are all clients also. When we go to the mall, of course, pag mahal, di ba, we tend to not buy. So the same thing is applicable to all the patients. All patients are consumers and clients. Okay? So we proceed with the clinics. So the clinics should have an investment, a budget investment of 35,000 that is good for 1,980 patients. Probably 2 years, babawiin, or 3 years. Now, mali po yung nasa taas 3 years. That is for 2 years lang. So 17 pesos, aerosol suction, 26 pesos, 8 pesos, and UV light ay 6 pesos. Here, air humidifier is 3 pesos. So, ganun lang po ang pag-compute. If you're going to all add up, and this is the total, lahat po yung pinagsama-sama natin. We have added dentist gastos, we have added patients gastos, we've also added the clinics gastos. And if you're in the introduction, it is just and right for you to add up 127.76 pesos. And if you're in the growth, well, you know, of course, your growth, it's for you to add 255.52. And if you're in maturity, you can add up 383.28. That is my computation. Of course, if you do have other computation that you feel it's right for your dental practice, you can also do so. But this is, for me, they're definitely inevitable for each and every dentist that you have to have add-ons. But you have to be logical. You have to be ethical. You have to be just. You have to be right. You have to be fair. You have to be equally balanced in everything that you do. So every time that you're going to add up, psychologically, there is also an effect for your for your patients. There will also an effect. Kaya we are trying to get into their brains by using our questionnaire forms pala. Okay? So that's how we do it. Right? It's easy to adjust, but it's not easy. The approach must be correct. If you're going to say, may additional kami, pagpasok pa lang, you're gonna give, the patients will definitely go to other practice. If the other practice will have a mind conditioning program, questionnaire, helping them, add-on is nothing. It's easy. They will definitely pay because patient pays based on experience. All right? So they should be happy at the same time. You always be smiling. Okay? So, mga minamahal na dentista, we have discussed the 3 phases that the dentist must analyze and realize. We have also discussed our new norms. You can always watch this in my YouTube for replays. KANO, we have discussed this one. And my final message is, number 1, Dr. Carmina, no, your words is really gratifying. Maraming salamat sa iyo. Number 1, do dental marketing not to get patients but build brand, professional branding. You have to do dental professional branding today. Ngayon po. Okay? Number 2, plan your business by doing an internal assessment. Nasaan ka na? Anong kakayahan mo? Ready ka na? Magaling ka na ba? Introduction, growth, maturity, period, o nasa decline stage ka na? And get realistic projections. Magkano ang kikitain mo? Magkano ang gusto mong kitain? Saan ka pupunta? Saan pa ka patutungo? Ano mong gustong marating? You want to be the best dental practice in the Philippines? Then you try to have you have to set several objectives and be positive, but be ready to start hard. Be positive, that is going to be hard. Charge correct based on your professional life cycle stage. So with all of that, that is my final message. Ito po ang gusto kong sabihin sa inyo, mga dentista kong mahal. You owe it to your patients, family, and of course, you. You. Kayo po yan. You can't fix if you don't know if it's broken. Currently, we know that we do have problems. There are parts of your practice that are broken and flawed. Instant trust, you have to have, and you have to have generate and build patience. Time to change your style of marketing starting today. Okay, so mga kaibigan, mga dentista, it's for you to realize that I did not scare you. I just warn you. And this is the things that we really love doing. So with that, so much learnings today. Napagod po ako, namaos ako, but I'm very happy that I was able to share this this webinar for you. Papakita ko po, ano? So, if you do have questions, maraming salamat po, no? I hope nag-enjoy kayo. Ang tagal po natin nagkwentuhan. Nag-enjoy din po ako sa pag-share ng mga natutunan ko throughout the years. If you do have, probably, we will entertain question the next time. Alam ko, pagod na kayo, but I think marami po kayo natutunan. Maraming salamat po. At anytime, you can reach us. Siguro, magkita-kita na lang po tayo sa May 15. It will be fun. And I hope that you stick with us. I'm going to continue serving Filipino dentists. No? Kami po ay may practice din. And I hope you learn a lot. Dr. Lani, Dr. Shara, Dr. Amanda, marami pong salamat sa pagpanonood nyo. Yan po ay malaking bagay na po yan para sa akin. Yan ang bayad nyo. At sa susunod, imbitahin mo nyo po ako sa mga chapter nyo. Imbitahin nyo po ako sa mga chapter ko. Medyo mahal nga lang po ako eh. Pero di ba ne? Ibigyan ko kayo ng discount. So, 1.5 hours, yun po yung pinakagusto ko. Pero 1 hour, medyo talagang bitin tayo sa question and answer. So I'm hoping that I'll be able to share with you in your chapter whatever topic that you'd like based on my experiences, based on the research, evidence-based. And with that, enjoy the rest of the night. I love you all. And stay beautiful, stay healthy, be positive. And ganun lang po talaga. We will get through this pandemic. Thank you very much. And you can watch all the replays. You can get all the certificates soon. We're going to watch the certificates in the YouTube channel. You can watch the replays in my YouTube channel. And you can get all the certificates very, very soon. We will announce it to you. You know, physical. Para po maipipresent sa PRC. With that, thank you very much. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Arigato gozaimasu. Good evening po. Good evening po.